Let me tell you about this girl. Maybe I should.
Hey guys.
Is the mic on?
The mic is on. Let us not do the same mic. Thing we did last week.
Ooh, that was crushing.
What's up, babe?
Hey, babes.
We're here for another episode of Brown Sugar Babe, the podcast. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for tuning in. So this week, this is episode 12.
Episode 12.
It's lit.
Y'all.
It's lit.
12 episodes. We started this in January.
We're still going.
I'm so excited. With the hectic schedules and all the rescheduling and moving the schedule.
We still made it.
It's been a lot. But it's been so much fun.
Oh my gosh. And I love it. And I don't want to stop. I thought I'd probably maybe it'll fade out or something.
Yeah. Nah.
No.
We ain't going nowhere.
Y'all we about to be on Apple Podcast.
We just working.
Y'all stuck with us forever.
Oh my gosh. Yay.
So, Chloe, how are you feeling?
How you feeling, girl?
I'm feeling chill, you know. Everything's good in my life. You know, one thing that I'm realizing, I love being single way too damn much. Because you know, when you start talking to people again, and they just start getting on your nerves, and it just be like, God damn it, this is why.
This is the reason.
This is the reason.
This is the reason why I stopped talking to
you. I like being in my own zen. Yeah, and you know, not to say, right. No one's bothering me, but it's just kind of like, you know, when you do talk to someone, y'all agree to disagree on some shit, and it's just kind of like, you know what? I didn't have this problem when I was by my damn self. Because I agree with me all the damn time.
Hashtag. Hold on.
But now you here, and now I got to agree to disagree and compromise with your ass, and I don't want
to
know.
I have to.
Girl, but no, everything's good. Work's good. Life's good. I'm chill. You know, I'm chill. That's how I feel this week.
Oh my gosh.
But Sanaa Babe.
Are we live again?
Yes, we are. It was fun last time. Sanaa Babe, how you feeling, boo?
I'm tired.
You tired? Are you physically tired, mentally tired?
After that conversation we just had, I'm fucking tired. Like I have nothing. I'm tired. I feel good, but I just realized how exhausted I was, and I'm just like, damn, girl. But keep pushing.
Are you doing things to help you ease exhaustion? Do you have any tips for the babes?
Give us a tip.
It's a crazy.
Because we all be there.
Just drink water. Drink lots of water. Drink lots of water and pray. Don't do anything without praying.
Yeah, absolutely.
I kid you not. What I'm doing right now, before every move I make, I'm praying Lord, is this what I'm supposed to be doing? If not, stop me in my tracks.
Amen. When I say I pray that every day,
anytime I feel some type of way, I be like, Lord.
Yeah.
I'm saying not even that. Every time I'm doing something, when I get up in the morning, I'm like, Lord, thank you. Thank you for allowing me to do this. Mm-hmm. Okay, so what am I doing today? What am I doing first? I'm all day. I'm like, okay, Lord, is this what I'm supposed to be doing?
Yeah.
Okay, what you want me to do next? That's all. I don't care about nothing else that's going on. I really haven't been in the social media. I'm not really hanging out much. I'm just I'm talking to me and God. We working on me, and I'm just tired right now. But I know I'm making breakthroughs, so I'm good.
No, you'll always be good, child. You will always.
You
be
will,
good.
Cause I know if I'm with God, I can't be touched. So
amen.
So that's why I'm staying right there. I'm not moving.
Oh man,
I'm
under the bosom and I'm there.
What about you, Lo? How you feeling?
I am feeling determined, you guys.
Okay.
I love to hear y'all story. Y'all so
determined
to continue to create
good habits.
Ooh.
Because I'm trying to consistently work out. And not for the sake of losing weight, but just for a healthy lifestyle.
Yeah.
As a part of my lifestyle.
Yeah.
And also other things like meditation and I don't know, being on time and giving myself enough time to,
I love that. I love when you're working on yourself.
So I'm just determined to do that because it's difficult. Those were my goals, in the beginning of the year or whatever.
Right,
It's been so difficult because I didn't fell off the bandwagon a couple times.
Me too.
Of course.
So I'm determined. You know how you get in that groove? Yeah. So I'm in a groove and I'm okay,
That's how I am right now. I'm not eating meat. I'm in a groove.
You know, it's hard too because you would think being about yourself would be the easiest thing that you can ever do in life. Mm-hmm. But it's like one of the hardest because I feel like this world would just kind of blow you just in so many different directions that you just forget. Like, God damn it, what about me? Yeah. So, it's good. I'm glad you said meditation because I was going to tell Sonara that you should really look into like meditation as
you
well.
You should look into like your chakras.
I was reading about that. Yeah, I was reading about that. You showed me some stuff before and I started looking into it. That's why I'm saying my peace. Like I'm just.
It's the most important thing ever.
Aligned.
That's, yeah. And that's, it, it's that's really important. Like
it's super important.
Because. Like, when you get mad, you know, like, your temper and stuff. Yeah. It's just kind of like, a lot of times you can, like, lose yourself in that. Like, you can lose yourself in trying to prove a point.
Yeah.
So, it's like, I want to say this, or I'm going to be upset, or I'm going to be doing that because I'm trying to prove a point when it's like, in actuality, you're losing your peace. Like, that person has that control over you. So, that's part of, like, last week when I was talking about God, like, showing me things, that was some of the things that he was showing me, just, like, protecting my peace and realizing that everything... Like, me even saying anything, you know, to someone about something else or me even reacting to something, that's what I mean. Me even reacting to something is more detrimental to me than it would be beneficial to
I was just going to say that. Not exactly. You know? Your reaction. It don't reserve, it doesn't, does everything so, does not deserve your energy. And that's where I'm at. Like, I'm not putting energy into
that. I had to tell a friend that the other day because you do run into a whole bunch of people that feel like everything needs a confrontation or everything, in your life needs an answer. Like, it needs some type of, like, end. And it's just like, no, it doesn't. Like, some things you just either don't learn to let go or you just don't know. And you just keep moving. That's why peace is so important because it doesn't matter with you having, like, peace. It doesn't matter what's going on in the world around you. It's just like, I'm good. Like, shit could just be, the world could be falling apart. And it's just like,
that's me right now. That's literally me right now. Like, I have a lot of shit that's like literally up in flames. And I'm just like, but I'm good. Like, my soul feels good. So, okay. They'll go out when they go out.
Yeah.
Or until I decide to put my energy into whatever that area is. But right now, I'm just kind of, it's like a bubble, and I'm just like looking at everybody like,
That's a beautiful bubble to be in.
It's amazing. I never want to get out.
It really is.
I never want to get out.
If you've been in like situations or bubbles to where it has been like anxiety and like worry and just being upset, and it's just like when you think about it, it's like, what am I really mad at?
Right.
Yeah. Is this is affecting me?
Yeah,
and I'm not talking to the person. I'm not trying to fix this issue.
Yeah.
So why am I allowing it to affect my mood? Like,
and who I am, and who I am,
and it causes you to put like a big old like thick piece of cardboard in front of like your blessing.
Mm-hmm.
So you just be walking around miserable and not even really feeling blessed at what God has even given.
Right. Yeah. Because you're so focused on the negative.
So focused on the negative. Yeah. Shit.
Me finding and being in my peace has really like reduced my anxiety by so much. I literally had an anxiety attack every day at one point up until the beginning of the year. Like, I had an anxiety attack about something every day, and it's fucking exhausting. And I'm I can't do this anymore. I can't do this. Mm-mm. And I'm now in my peace. I'm like, it feels good to be on the other side. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't care. Like, I can say I don't care and mean that shit.
Yeah.
And I just be like, whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Back to me. I love when we talk about our feelings at the beginning. Like, it's like it's like a wellness segment.
A wellness segment.
We're in touch with our feelings. It's nice.
A wellness segment.
I love, okay.
Coco.
What's that?
Run that Listen Linda, baby.
Hey. Yeah, we haven't done Listen Linda in a minute.
It's a good one.
So, I was on Instagram earlier today, and I ran across this post, and I'm going to read it to you guys, and we're going to kind of, you know, decide and figure this out. So, it says, my confession is I don't love my husband of 10 years. He had a baby on me, constantly cheated, and now he thinks everything is cool because I didn't leave. Well, the gag is, due to me living rent-free, I've been able to fix my credit, save money, and now I'm about to move out of town with him. His dick is little. His tongue is trash. He broke. he broke and he lied all the time. Why did I stay? I needed to come up. No bills for 4 years. Hell yeah, I stayed. Now I'm over it. Adios. So, in a nutshell, if you really weren't paying attention to that, more of the story. This woman has been married for 10 years. Her husband cheated. She stayed because she was saving and stacking money and preparing for her departure. So now, basically,
we're taking off.
So now that she has enough money saved up in her account, she's out. So, thoughts about this?
Man, I think on one end, I think it was smart of her to do that. Because she was thinking about herself. He obviously wasn't thinking about her.
So why?
And he wanted to disrespect her, so she decided to get what she could out of the deal. So I really don't feel to say that she was wrong would be me having sympathy for him, and I don't.
Yeah.
Because he was being disrespectful. So what was she supposed to do? Leave when he, like, no, fuck that. Like, run his ass over. Like, he ran you over. So run his ass over. Like,
what's
it is very fair. I don't see any other way. The only wrong could be like, oh, you took advantage of a man you didn't really want. You basically, like, you know, you didn't steal from him, but you was kind of, you know, with him. You didn't really love him. But
you have a baby on me?
But I married you, though. So clearly I loved you, but you had a baby on me. So that's not my fault.
Once you had a baby on me, all gloves are off.
You know.
All gloves are off once you have a baby on me. Yeah. So you gon'.
It took me a while to, like, really, because when I was going through the comments, everyone was just like, yes, bitch, like, that's how you do it. Go, good for you. Good job. Blah, blah, blah. But what I just kept sticking at the fact, like, 10 years. Like, he had a baby on you, cheated on you, lied, and you stayed there for 10 years?
Wow. Maybe that was a 10 years she needed to get her credit right.
Probably, you know?
If so it was it's in not, five, yeah. probably
right. It's not a bad move by no means, because it's like, you definitely could have just left him, and he would have been like, oh. But not only did you leave, but you glowed up on that ass as you left. So he really finna hurt.
And I'm also pretty sure that she had her moments to where she was trying to make it work, and it may have not gone in her favor. Like, within 10 years, I'm pretty sure that she probably had those thoughts to where it's like, oh, you know, maybe we could work it out, and he did some more stupid-ass shit. And she was like, okay, nigga, fuck you. Like, no, I'm done.
Y'all, let me tell you this. People only do what you allow. So if he didn't care enough to see what the fuck she was doing to him, shit. He didn't care.
A fucking baby.
People do what you allow
them to
do.
You know what? Ironic enough, I was watching Dr. Phil this morning. Dr. Phil. And it was when is your left hand and me about to get some money?
I hope so, baby.
You said what?
When you scratch your hand and me about to get
some money. Yeah, you itch your left money. I don't know which hand, but they usually say when your hand inches, you about to go up to some money.
Ooh, you know what they say about when your palm
is. My palms is, you know. Yeah. Okay, so I was watching Dr. Phil this morning, and it was a black couple. It had to be some niggas.
Damn.
And dude was married to this woman, and he had a baby on her with his ex. But come to find out, the ex was his ex-wife, and he cheated on his ex-wife with his now wife.
Oh, wow.
The wife is on the show now.
Oh, wow.
And so Dr. Phil was like, who's a cheater? I was a cheater. How did you ever think that he was
You lose him how you get
but
him.
But anyway, it's just ironic that was on there when we talk about the same thing with Liz and Linda. But that's crazy. I don't know. Like, I with a baby, I don't know. I feel like she, for her benefit, baby. For what she did, I mean, that was for her benefit. And she got what she needed out of the deal. And
we have to stop normalizing the fact that a man is going to hurt you. If we have to stop normalizing,
what you mean?
Like, he gonna do shit. We're gonna look past the fact that he cheated. Not only did he cheat, he got someone pregnant. Not only did he get someone pregnant, the child is now his responsibility. Mm-hmm.
That's a whole.
We're not gonna act like that's not. No, we're not gonna. No, because I see so many people like, okay, all men cheat. No, we're not gonna normalize that. That's not gonna be okay. I know you're gonna cheat on me, so whatever. No, once you had that baby. All gloves are off.
But see, I think with this story, it was just more of like, they got married. No, they were married. They were probably happy for the first 2 or 3 years or something. Mm-hmm. Some shit happened. He started cheating. He had a baby. He kept lying. And her thing was, it's like, you know, I could either just up and leave. Yeah. Or I could sit here, stack this bread, make this paper, and then leave.
It's not the how you play your hand.
She just, one thing, and we said it before we started this podcast, it's like, me and my patience, I don't think I would have had the patience to stay there for 10 fucking years and just be completely unhappy and even more depressed.
And
what are we doing?
What are we even doing? doing?
Why did we even get married? For love.
This love got to do.
What? Come on, baby.
Sometimes that, for that honestly really be my thing.
Yeah.
I love a lot of things.
I'm not going, no, you need to be doing a lot more. Because she said his dick is little, his tongue is trash, and he broke.
And he had the nerve to stick that little Peter Wacker
and make a whole child. Was he? That's my. Those are my questions.
He broke. So why y'all ain't having kids?
What was his? Did you know this before y'all got married? Why did you marry?
Wait a minute, bitch. Wait a minute. Roll back the motherfucking tape, bitch. You stupid.
You stupid. I've been waiting for people to do this.
You stupid because, bitch, please. His dick wasn't little when you buried him.
Yeah.
His dick wasn't little before he had that baby on you. Shut the hell up. His dick ain't little. You like that little dick. So, on that end, whatever.
When the bills was paid, dude.
I don't know about the bills, but when you got with
him. So, how her bills paid if he broke?
That's whatever. So that was another thing that was happening in the comments. A whole
rent free whale in a box.
Yeah, a couple of girls was
session
just
eight,
like,
mm-hmm.
No. What? See, a couple of girls was just like, something don't sound right. How you give you free rent? You able to stack up your money, but
y'all
you told me that he broke. I don't know.
Where y'all at?
That was
because rent high.
Okay.
So you broke.
He ain't broke.
Because nah, she broke. Not paying he paying the rent all by himself. So he not
so
broke.
He from the bitterness.
And if he broke, it's just because I'm paying all the bills.
Yeah.
That's probably why he cheated.
And he got another kid. That's why he broke.
That's probably why he cheated. Like, you just sitting in the damn house. See, I want everybody to stop being nice. Like, kudos to you, bitch. Okay, good for you.
Yeah.
But it's just like, bitch, but what were you doing? If you not paying no rent, what are you doing? He probably
said rent-free.
Rent-free.
So that means bill-free.
Yeah.
Because bills is hard too. So your cell phone bill, your car note, your insurance, that's a whole rent. That's rent right there again. What happened? I think she was just sitting there on her ass. She wasn't doing nothing.
Yeah, he probably cheated with his sugar mama
she
and ended up getting that pregnant because I had to give more money.
He probably cheated because he was tired of, No.
Oh, it's not negating the fact that he cheated. He's still whack as shit for that. But
it is.
My thing is tell the whole story. You know, women, when we break up with people,
we always tell the bad.
Yeah.
But see, I never lie on a dick. That's one thing I'm not going to do.
For what?
And if you ain't got a little dick, I ain't going to say you got a little dick. So if
I'm
you got a little dick,
I've been the one
that's been. I'm not going to talk about your penis because, I mean, hey.
I've been right. That's been mine for a while.
If I talk about it after, I was talking about it while during it. Straight like that.
I
was talking about it.
Commemorate.
You know what I'm talking about.
I already know who you talking
and
about.
And I was like, that, but I don't know. Hold on. That
oh, okay.
That, you know, that was before I got into my relationship with my baby.
I just be like, why?
Have y'all been with little penis before?
No. I don't think so. I think I've been with either average or large.
God,
no, ma'am.
You had something like that?
Yeah. The stories I could tell. I'm gonna write a book. That really sounds really bad. No, not the stories I could tell about sex. That really sounds really bad because that makes it seem like I've just been like frivolously. Blah, blah, blah.
Some girls have a great sex life. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
But no, I'm gonna write a book.
You've been with someone whose penis size is the same size as his lighter. Don't play this man like that.
I'm
really?
Sorry.
It was very small.
So
and I don't know if it was. And I don't know if it was just because I know it was soft. Because
come on.
That was it. No, I don't know. I did not do that. But you know all that. But no. And it was very small, and I got up and left, and I went to my boo house.
Yeah.
I packed my bag while he was gone. I was like, I gotta go.
Chick-fil-A.
I made it seem like, you know, it hurt. And, you know,
Wow.
I hate Lori.
I mean, I didn't ruin his self-esteem. At least I'm nice.
Yeah.
Right?
That's true.
Cool. I could have been like, I'm little dick at it. I was like, oh my God. It's
like a little orgasm here and there. And
I was like, it's too much.
That's normal.
But that was like back when I was like back in it. That was like in Atlanta. Like, I was like, really young.
Yeah.
I was like a wow, girl.
Wow.
Wow.
You're so silly. So,
today.
Oh, yeah. What are we talking about?
Are we doing a sound off today, or are we just going to let the rest of it? You say you have something to sound off on.
I did have something to sound off on. I just want us as black women to, especially black women. Women, period. I just want us to always encourage each other.
Yeah.
And stop separating ourselves and picking on each other and picking apart each other based on what we see as beautiful or what we see as normal, we see as who the fuck we want it to be.
Yeah.
And just support the woman for, you know, who she is. She's a soul. She is a female just like you. And she may go through the same struggles you have, if not more, than you have. And especially black women or women of color, or like the fuck, like we go through a lot as well, like even more because we are of color. So you can't walk around here talking shit about one another and picking on people, picking apart people for who they are as a person. Like, who the fuck are you? Stay in your goddamn bubble. And I'm talking about Azealia motherfucking Banks.
And her. I like how you set that up. Yeah. That was nice.
I'm talking about her and her weird ass. And yes, I just said you shouldn't basically judge people, but I'm judging her because she walk around here judging everybody else and talking her shit. And it's very disheartening because she tears people down.
Yeah.
She uses her platform to tear people down. And I don't, and you're right, she has a right to free speech. She has a right to express herself. But it's like, you don't express it in a caring way, a compassionate way. You express it in a negative way. It's like you have ulterior motives and it's very vindictive and it's just horrible. Yeah. And it's like, she came for Cardi, and people have their opinions about Cardi, but this girl, she got her own career. Like, let her flourish. Like, it's random people.
She found her lane.
It's niggas out here with tattoos on their face that literally look like Satan's children if Satan had kids. But y'all listen to their music, and they can hop around on stage. It's niggas around here. Look, we all have our opinions about people, but you don't have to. Globally, like, you don't have to sound off like how I'm doing about another person's personality. It just makes you look really weird.
Yeah, especially because she's such a public figure. Like, it's easy for little old us to sit in a room and talk about
whatever. But you're an actual artist.
Yeah.
So you run in these circles. Maybe not. Because I don't know how many people fuck with you, Azealia.
At this point.
Before this.
Are her songs?
I never heard. And if you called it, she didn't come. Tiana came, but she didn't come to the table for Tiana.
Yeah,
Tell me why you didn't come to the table for Tiana. Tiana was like, wait a minute.
She got time. Back to sleep.
Mother's Day was yesterday. Hello. I'm here. Now, what was said? And you didn't come to the table for her, so help me understand. But help me understand why you're coming to the table at all.
Yeah.
I thought she comes to the table by herself. She talks her shit until a whole bunch of people are like, oh my God. So she gets all these raves.
And then she goes away.
She goes back and forth. Like, I don't like it, and I feel like she really needs to, like, regardless, she needs to come a different way. If she has these opinions, like, call these people on the phone, talk to them directly.
Let's have lunch.
But to continue to blast off on social media about it, it's really petty, it's disheartening, and it really represents a very bad example for what a lot of women went through when they were growing up. Mm-hmm. Women who bully them, and women who talk shit about them just for being themselves.
Yeah.
So, babes, I just want y'all, if you are the type of female, I still love you with the love of God. Catch it
with the love of God. With the love of God.
But don't be like that. Like, you don't gotta love everybody and you don't gotta like everybody, but we gotta respect people.
Yeah.
It just want people to respect you.
These are all facts. And it just makes me laugh because I just do not know who she is.
I don't even know. I didn't know who she was until she came for SZA. Did she come to SZA?
Calling her niece.
I don't like what the fuck. Because
they have the same outfit.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Me neither. Babes, if y'all could, can some of y'all send us some of her songs if y'all know it? At brownsugarbabepod@gmail.com.
Yeah, I tried to listen to her interview on the Breakfast Club, and I'm just kind of like, you listen to her talk, she seems like the dorkiest, nerdiest black girl. Like, she seemed like if she was nice, the outsider, but she seemed like she would be cool. Like, if she really put as much energy as she does to social media, to her music, she'd probably be a relatable, cool ass chick. But it's just like, I don't.
Do you think what she says, she projects, like, she's projecting who she is onto other people, or she tries to bully people before they bully her because she went through bullying growing up?
Probably.
Do you feel like girls hate for her?
Who's to know? I don't know. I just, I know she don't seem like the type. I can't remember her backstory based off the interview, but she doesn't seem like she came from like a hard life or I don't know. I just think she just trying to find clout, and this is the only reason. This is the only way that we would. I'm telling you, I feel like I would not know who Azealia Banks is if it was not for the Shade Room.
Yeah.
So I feel like this is the only way that she can remain any type of credibility is if she's talking about people, because we damn for sure ain't finna listen to her music. I do not know one of her songs. Duh. And I tried to Google it because I'm like, maybe I just don't, you know her name, but I'm pretty sure I've heard one of her songs before. Yeah. And I'm like, but I haven't. I don't know what she is.
Good. Dressing like how she. Girl, you see how she pulled up to the. I said, well, now wait a minute. How you gonna be just like somebody on the internet?
Yeah, she's a
talking shit. And then you come in person and you look like a damn Sprite can. A Sprite can witch. That's what she looked like. She had on this shiny green dress with some gloves. I was like, what the fuck? What is this coming up to the Breakfast Club like this?
She's ridiculous.
She's a creative. Let me not. Don't judge. I'm not trying to judge her. Let me stop.
Right.
She was cute in her own way.
There you go. Woman empowerment. Woman so empowerment. Proud of you.
I'm sorry. Thanks.
There you go.
Thanks, Julie. Oh, really?
But we go up. Right. Look at her. This is her. We don't know her. You don't even go here.
Azealia Banks, Breakfast Club. Breakfast Club. And see what she has. I promise you she looked like. She looked like the What's the cookie? Tabisco. What is it?
Who is Tabisco? Cookie Monster?
No, y'all know the cookies that the commercial be having the trees.
Like the Toll House.
Y'all know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
I have no
Toll House, and it be him and his like brothers.
You know the little thing he be having a little jacket he be having on.
Yeah. You're so goofy. I cannot.
Really?
All right, glasses up, ladies. Glasses up.
I'm the only one with a glass. They got wine.
Smoothie King.
I ain't even got. I already drank my wine.
All right, so today's topic is light. It's different. We're talking about fitness. Summer 2018 is basically here. If you stay in Houston,
man, right?
It's hot as hell. We breaking record temps and everything this week. So, in lieu of summer, we are talking about fitness, body, diets, what we do to try to lose weight, get right, and stuff. We had a guest, but his whack ass canceled because he's quote unquote sick.
Wait!
I'm just kidding.
I walked in like I'm about to trash in this. What is that? His whack ass. Look, she did for me. Thank you.
I'm just kidding. Shout out to he's not feeling well.
We hope you're feeling well.
Shout out to DT, Young Splashy. But, I don't even know how we start this because we really didn't.
Well, okay.
You got a question?
No, I don't have a question, but should we start off by, like, what we've been doing? Like, what our goals are for our body goals?
Oh, my God. Our health goals, whatever.
Or summer goals. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
I was talking about swimsuit while we were sitting here for the summer. It's so fucking cute.
I have so many swimsuits. And it's motivating.
Like, look.
I think that's really cute.
That is really cute.
I think that's the best thing you could do.
It's like a nice little top, like a little crop top, y'all. It got, like, these Aztec print on it. Show the live.
Look at her. Show the live. That's Sonara's future swimsuit.
Yeah, I'm about to see me there when I go to the...
Because I'm going to the Bahamas in September for my dad's wedding.
That's going to be nice.
That's
plenty of time to get the body right and tight.
I'm really trying to be toned. I'm really just trying to be, like, toned up. And, like, I want my waist to be snatched.
Yeah.
And... I don't know.
Hi, Rome.
Oh, hey, Rome. Hey. I really want to. I want to be toned, and I just want to be able to wear like a nice crop. Yo, thank you.
Yeah. But I just want to crop top. I told
you know, and a crop top. Yeah. And I just want to. I want to feel like just like you know, light, and like I'm just trying to get my digestion together.
Yeah,
And I feel like I know that starts with like. What I eat and stuff like that, and like drinking water, and I'm just really just trying to get all vegetables. That, you know, get on consistent. Like I said before, trying to get.
So what's your plan? What are you doing?
Okay, so I've been using the Nike Train app.
Uh-huh. It's the best, right?
Right. So basically, the Nike Train app it allows you to put in like how often you work out, like where you see yourself. Are you a beginner? Are you intermediate? Are you advanced? How often you work out? And then they ask you, like, what your goals are, like, mm-hmm. what you're trying to do, whatever. Of course, they ask you your weight and your height.
Right.
And so then they set up, like, a workout plan for you. So the first day, y'all, when I tell y'all, my legs, I needed a wheelchair for real.
Oh, yeah. That's always going to be the
worst. Like, day. When I, and it's very easy. They show you, like, it's somebody that's, like, actually showing you. And it's not, like, a little stick figure. It's an actual human being. Like, yeah. That's showing you how the workouts go. And, yeah. Y'all, it was, and it is very easy, and it's not hard. It's not hard yet. And I've rested for the last 3 days. And it tells you to rest and tells you to stretch and stuff. Oh. So I rested for the last 3 days. And I'm trying to, like, eat better. I don't eat bad. But, yeah. And that's honestly about it. I just want to get better at, like, being more active. Like, I want to run.
Yeah, I want to be running.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I want to feel inside, like, feel a lot, like, better.
It's amazing. I feel like I feel my best when I'm working out. So.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah. Ooh, it just makes you feel, your body feel different. I can tell my body when I'm working out and I've been consistent.
Yeah.
And when I fell off and I'm just like, fuck it.
So what are your plans? Because we know you've been trying to get it right, get it tight.
You got a trainer, girl.
Right, we seen you on the ground.
We seen you on the ground.
Right, no, for real, that's really what I have to do because I have such a busy schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Everything has to be pre-made. Everything has to be like right on the money so I can get that 30 minutes, that 45 minutes, that hour in the gym. Like, I work out every day, Monday through Friday. Sometimes Saturday if I can, but I try to. That's just my time. I'm working out, and I'm eating right, and I like the way I eat. Like, eating clean makes me feel better than eating gravy. And I'm gonna still eat gumbo, baby.
She said,
"Okay, when it comes, pause.
Out of all the food, Sonara could have said that it made her feel heavy. Bruh. She said gravy.
Because I love some rice and gravy. Okay,
rice and gravy. Okay, honey.
Ooh, I love me rice and gravy.
She said gravy. That's, I can't remember the last time I had rice and gravy. Though, no, it's good. Keep going.
My hair that up. But I'm gonna eat gumbo. I still like crawfish. I like the seafood boys and stuff like that. But for my goal was this year to eat cleaner or eat healthier more than I did eat healthier. But now it's just turned into me. That's just how I eat, and I'm good with that. And that's stuff that I like. You see, I got these vegan bites. Like, I like, I enjoy those.
Yeah.
So that and working out, and I'm not like I usually stop because it's not working. But it's literally a lifestyle. It's not a diet. Some people tell me, "Are you on a diet?" I'm like, "No, this is how I eat.
Yeah,
I like this food."
So you, me and Lo know, but the babes don't know. The babes and the bows. Yeah. You have given up meat.
Yeah.
For 2 weeks now.
Yeah.
How has that been?
It makes you feel lighter. Like, I eat fish, shrimp, but other than that, like, it's veggies.
Do you have a lot more energy these days?
I mean,
or is it kind of the same?
I'm always tired because I got kids. So, but come on. I noticed I can stay up later if I wanted to, or I go to bed earlier because I know I want to feel better the next day. So I think sleep is just as much a part of your health as eating right and exercising, because you have to get sleep or your body doesn't rest, so it's not going to function properly.
Yeah. Do you crave the meat?
No, because chicken, it was hard for me.
Yeah.
I love chicken. Like, Timmy Chan's chicken wings, Wingstop, like, that's me.
Look at his mouth.
Why do people love Timmy Chan's?
Oh, that's a Friday spot. It's either Timmy Chan's, JJ's, or Wingstop. I love Wingstop.
Timmy Chan still be having the feathers on their damn wings.
Ooh, I experienced that,
but I ain't had one yet.
Yeah. I don't like
that. How many of y'all know Timmy Chan still got the feathers on their wings?
No,
give us a hello, hi, hi.
No, yeah, if you're listening on Instagram Live, look at Rome. He said Chicken Plus.
It's what is Chicken Plus?
I have no.
Oh, see, don't Rome, tell me about no places.
Where's Chicken Plus?
Lotus and
Lotus. Yeah. I love Lotus.
Lotus? Baby.
Girl, but they don't sell chicken, they seafood.
So I could probably eat there.
Get that loud package.
Get the loud package.
Where is that?
Shrimp and rice. And Lotus is up the street. Yeah, there's one on Braeswood, and then there's one up the street here on Westheimer and Kirkwood.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try it.
It's good.
It's good.
Like seafood.
What about you?
Rome said Chicken Plus is on the north side.
All right. Hell
no. No one's going to the north side.
Like, no. Thank y'all.
You look good, Chloe. Like, you.
Oh,
what are you doing? What have you been doing?
Because Chloe got on a crop top.
Okay, honey.
And I'm jealous as hell.
Girl.
Stop it.
It's a look.
Stop it. No, I put on a lot of weight when I went to college, of course. Like, and a lot of that came literally from the alcohol. I feel like it. We was drinking all the time. And, of course, the dining halls, you're just eating just because. So, I put on a lot of weight. When I got out of college, I lost a lot. And that came from not drinking as much. Uh-huh. But then I just changed my lifestyle of eating. Yeah, so what it is that it really is a lifestyle. I try to stay away from carbs as much as I can, especially when I'm on a diet. Bread, women and bread, or at least me and bread, we don't get along at all. Like, that has spread me out anytime.
Yeah.
So bread, pasta, I try not to eat that as much. As a lifestyle diet, what I do is try to eat clean during the week. Yeah, so I eat like that. If you can eat clean Monday through Friday, Saturday, Sunday, you know, you can cheat and have your fun. I think that's a safe like lifestyle bet for anybody. Like, whenever your weekend is, just eating. I knew your phone would do that because I knew it would die. So I put it on mine. Yeah. But I eat clean during the week. At least I try to. It's been a while. I'm actually trying to get back on a diet plan because I feel like I'm still in Thailand. And I've been kicking it. I'm not even gonna lie. I am still in Thailand and I have been kicking it. So I'm definitely trying to get back right. You know, I eat a lot of sandwiches. Yep. I try to stay away from grease and fried food. That's really what it is. I don't eat a lot of fried chicken. Like, I'm not the one that be craving Popeyes on a Tuesday.
Yeah, I haven't even had Popeyes. I haven't had Popeyes all year.
I do not crave Popeyes at all. I really don't eat fast food fried chicken. I really don't eat fried chicken like that. In all honesty, I probably the most fried food I probably eat is fried fish or fried shrimp. Other than that, I really try not to eat too much fried food. I work out a lot. I have a trainer. Shout out to Deuce Fit Q. I work out with him at least 2 times a week. I went running today in the park, though. You know, I hate running. I'm not going to lie. I hate running.
I love it.
But it is the best, I think, exercise that you can do. And what I tell people, because everybody thinks they need to, like, run 5 miles or around the neighborhood. It only takes 30 minutes of cardio a day. And you can literally eat whatever you want to if you're not trying to lose weight.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of, like, low. I'm at a spot now where it's just, like, I'm really not trying to lose weight. I'm trying to tone everything. I just want it nice and tight, you know.
Suck it in tight. Get it right.
The little muscles in there, you know, suck it in, get some muscles, and just show it out.
Exactly.
And of course,
I want this midsection.
Then, you know, we as women had problems with that midsection.
We gotta go.
It's the hardest thing to lose. But they say, what do they say helps with the midsection? I think that's like beans and greens, avocado, spinach. Yeah. I think a lot of greens.
I eat
peanuts.
A lot of green veggies.
Peanuts help. See, I don't eat peanuts or peanut butter, and I hear that's the best type of little snack that you can eat. It's like peanuts and peanut butter. I don't eat none of that. I hate peanuts. I hate almonds.
Oh, man.
If you're listening, hi, Gabriel.
Okay.
What?
What you about to say? My bad.
No, I had nothing.
Okay. So, I actually got this tip from somebody because I was talking about my stomach and I was like, man, my midsection, I really just want to lose it. Like, and they was like, that's all? You just want to lose it?
You just want to stomach?
I was like, yes. So, they was like, I got something for you. So they wrote this down for me. They said something called Swiss Chris, right?
Uh-huh. And Swiss Chris.
Swiss Chris.
Okay.
Okay. And they says $8.99 from like Walmart, CVS, or whatever.
Okay.
And they said week one, take 4 the first night before bed.
Are these pills?
These are pills.
Okay.
Right? And 3 every night after. And there was like, and then week 2, you take 2 every night before bed. Okay. And they was like, call me after. And they was like, I promise you, after week 2, you're going to want to run to work. Because you're going to have so much energy.
Sound like speed to me. That's what the pills be.
What kind of drug is it?
No, it's not a drug. It's
crack.
I looked it up.
It's like a vitamin.
Yeah, it's all natural.
Have you tried it yet?
Well, she like, because when you like call me, I'm like, call you for what?
I haven't tried it yet, but I just wanted to share just in case.
Okay, say it again. Say it again for the babes and the bros.
Chris. And
you can find it at your local.
You can find it at your local Walmart.
It's a laxative.
Oh, it's going to have me shit. Hell nah. It has to be like a smooth.
But the reviews are 4.8.
It's 4 and it's 5 on Amazon. So, this is what I'm saying, you guys. Although, I don't really like laxatives either, I'm going to try it. If y'all babes want to try it with me,
What we going to get?
I'm going to let y'all two try it first, and then let me know how it goes. Because I just despise accident. And you know what? I drink a smooth move tea.
Wait. We're going to sit here and act like, Chloe say smooth move. A smooth move tea.
That's what it's called.
You drink that when you're on a high diet. Smooth
move.
Smooth
move. What that mean? It's a smooth move.
What that mean? Well, smoothly move all the shit out your body?
Basically. Because, you know, the one thing that I hate about laxative, I hate cramps. Like, I hate stomach cramps. Yeah. So, if these things don't make me cramp, I'm all for it. I don't know if y'all ever heard of the sea salt cleanse, too.
Yeah.
That doesn't make me cramp. I've done that before. Yeah, the sea salt cleanse. It gets it out, and it doesn't cramp you up. So, I really like that. I've done it once, and I really want to do it again.
No. But the magnesium citrate, that cramps you up.
I don't like anything that cramps me up.
And then it comes out.
No, the smooth move tea, you cramp up, but it's not a bad cramp. It's enough to where it's just like, gotta go. Maybe and you go to the restroom and you poop it out.
Oh, baby. You feel like you get the sweating and stuff.
Okay, that's not okay. Are y'all against laxatives or for laxatives?
I don't have a problem with it. I see a lot of people online like talking about the tummy, what is it?
Flat tummy tea.
Does that work? Like not healthy if you do it a lot.
I'm sure nothing.
You're not supposed to have like a diarrhea type poop every day. Like that's not okay. Because not diarrhea is not okay. Like if you have diarrhea,
liquid.
Yeah, if it's like liquid and soft,
it should have some type of form.
Your stool should have a form.
It should not be.
So if it's coming out weak and smooth, that means it's kind of like diarrhea. And diarrhea means like you ate something bad. Like if something's wrong, you know. I'd be so happy though when I poop like that because I'd be like, ooh, I'm cleansing, but it's not a good thing.
It should be like once a month type of thing.
Yeah. If you pooping soft a lot, you might want to go see the doctor.
It should be solid. Definitely solid.
I mean, it's solid.
Come on, wellness.
You know what's crazy? Do y'all poop every day? Yes, I'm sorry, this is really personal.
I don't.
I probably poop at least three or four times a day.
Yeah, really?
Yes. Every time I eat, I go like at least 10 to 15 minutes after I eat. That's me.
That's regular. Like that. You're supposed to go every meal.
I do not poop every day. I think I've always been like that, though. Well, you know, when
cold?
I was...
You need more fiber.
No. I probably need more fiber in my
granola.
Diet.
Granola.
Look.
Get you some granola.
Or some avocado bars. Or something.
Get you some... Or prunes.
I heard prunes.
You know, I could drink prune juice.
I never had prune juice.
I had to, and it was a point in time where I didn't poop for like 5 days.
No,
and I had to go get some prune juice. I don't know why. I didn't like that.
And you drink water all the time, right?
Yeah, I don't drink soda, juice, or nothing.
I drink apple juice all the time too.
That's why apple juice is a natural laxative.
So that's
and apples. Yeah, it's good though. You're supposed to go after every meal.
I wish. That's all I buy.
Like, I don't buy any other juice but apple juice. Yeah. Like, I literally drink apple juice.
I'm going to try that because I would be the skinniest bitch in the world if I could poop all the time. Like, I be kids standing in people who poop, like, at the every meal. They got to go.
That's regular.
Because I got all the apple juice in the world. And I shit like that. And you'll see my ass is skinny. My ass is not skinny. Okay.
Girl, where is the fat loss?
Girl, like, if it wasn't on live, I'd pull my shirt up.
Get out of here.
Y'all want to see it?
Girl.
Oh my
y'all
god.
Y'all wanna see my stomach?
Girl.
Let me tell y'all, since we're talking about health and wellness. This lady walked in my office the other day.
She was like, she came out of her appointment, she said, "Did you know that we have wood chips? They put wood chips in our food." I said, "What?
What is a wood chip?"
Like wood chips, like wood, like if you
mulch
wood. Yeah. Like if you put a piece of wood in one of them little blenders, wood chips.
Okay.
So she pulled out printed documentation from the internet.
From the internet, because that's the most reliable source.
Out of her purse. I kid you not, bro. And she was like, "See, look." I said, "Oh, shit." Y'all, on the article, it said they put wood chips in, like, everything. Like, everything. They put wood chips in soda, they put wood chips in chips, they put wood chips in all processed foods. They put wood chips in everything. I just thought it was really funny that she had that in her purse. But it was also very, like, I was like, wow. Like, it was interesting to me. Because I'm like, is that true? Because, you know, a lot of people have so many conspiracies about shit.
Yeah.
Have you heard about that
before? Like, have you seen that person that made that lettuce?
Damn vegans.
Right, I'm like, what the? Oh, this is the reason why I said that. Because you said something about, okay. So yeah. Then she was talking about how that there's some type of something that's in most of the foods that we eat that it's like something that we can't digest. And she was like, you know how a lot of times.
You know, you can't digest corn. That fucks me up because I love
corn. It comes out of your poop.
That's what I'm saying. You can't digest it. That's why it comes out like corn.
As long as it comes out.
As much as we.
I've never looked at my poop and see that it came out like corn.
I always see corn. I always see.
Can we talk about this? I always see spinach. I always see like greens.
Yeah.
It always
really?
Yeah.
Maybe I just don't look at my poop.
Right. Okay.
That's another thing you need. A part of wellness, you have to look at your poop. You have to analyze it because it tells you.
I heard when you eat healthy, like when your poop floats, that means it's a good thing. Like when your poop is floating, really? And you can't really smell it, it's good. And
that means that means
you're eating healthy. Yeah, they said. Yeah, I think so.
Okay, no, this is what I was saying about the stomach stuff.
Yeah.
So what she was saying was it was a chemical that we can't digest it, so it sits there. So she was like, you know how a lot of people when they try to lose their stomach and they can't,
yeah,
it's because it's like
chemical
sitting there. So I was like, look at me. I'm like, so what do you do? Like, don't sit there and tell me. You know what I'm saying?
The answer?
She was like, well, you know, you know how people start looking around like, oh shit. Mm-hmm. She was like, well, you just have to just eat as healthy as possible. You have to eat as healthy as possible, and you just have to just process it out. You just have to just do as much as you can, and just eat as healthy as possible so that your body can just
get better, I guess.
To heal.
I guess.
So, what can I eat to not eat that chemical? What is the chemical not in? She don't answer a lot of questions for
she
me.
She was like
don't
everything.
Be putting me on game if you don't.
No, your poop, healthy poop sinks.
My poop.
Floating. It says floating sick. Stools are often an indication of high fat content.
Of
malabsorption.
God,
my poop.
Thank God for the Google. Cause Chloe went ahead and everybody like whoop de doo. Everybody are all fat.
All that shit. My poop floats. I'm good.
My poop sinks. Baby.
My bad. Yeah.
It be doop.
I retract my last statement. So apparently,
it's supposed to flow. It's supposed to be a certain color.
Is it supposed to flow or supposed to sink?
It's supposed to sink. I'm sorry. It's supposed to sink. That's what
Chloe, it's yours be sinking or flow?
I told y'all I do not look at my poop enough to know this. I think most of the time, why? Y'all turn around and look at y'all poop?
Hell yeah.
I want to see. Okay, because my dad found about issues from his health from his poop. Like, had he not looked, he wouldn't have known.
I mean, sometimes, but I don't be sitting there analyzing it like,
I mean,
oh.
I know it's not. No, first of all, I'm not poking the shit.
No, I don't poke it. I just look
when
at it.
You know how you turn around when you about to touch the toilet? You know how you turn around you're like, ooh, and you see, you're like, oh, okay.
Okay, you good.
Right.
Okay. I promise y'all, tomorrow,
no.
If I poop, because like I say, I don't poop every day. If I poop. I'll take some apple juice.
You want some apple juice?
Let me get some apple juice. Thanks, babe. But tomorrow, I will turn around and look at my poop and see if it floats or sinks. I'm going to text y'all, too. I'm like, oh, y'all. It's up.
Yeah.
It's up.
It's up.
Oh, my God.
This conversation is cracking me up. We didn't mean to take it, though, but we did.
I mean, but you need to know.
Oh, that's so funny. That's so funny. I think we just taught the babe something. Look, Lo don't even have that much apple juice because he's sitting there drinking the shit out of apple juice.
That's good enough for you. You
don't
go out
there.
Oh, wait.
That's so funny.
What about kombucha? I love me some kombucha. Girl. Let's talk about it.
What is kombucha? If y'all didn't hear Lo because she way over there.
Right?
Like, y'all can hear her. But she said, come back and say it. What?
Kombucha. I drink kombucha. And kombucha is a probiotic, and it's supposed to, it's like, it helps with, like, you know.
Green tea,
body
too.
I drink a lot of green tea.
That's good.
But green tea is good for my metabolism and my energy.
It tastes weird. I like a regular tea.
It's really good.
I like Jamaica. Jamaica's good.
I never had Jamaica.
Not the, not the sugary kind, but it shouldn't taste super sweet.
Mm-hmm.
I fell in love with that. It's good, and it's good for weight loss, but I just like the way it tastes.
And also, I used to think that doing, like, going the healthy route is expensive, but it's not as expensive as you think.
No,
honestly, if you
not.
Put your mind to it and you really research it, then you can find, like, alternatives that are cheaper.
And sales.
If you go to, like, Trader Joe's and like Sprouts and stuff. Those are like cheaper alternatives. You don't have to go to fucking Whole Foods. Whole Foods,
because I get all my healthy stuff out of HEB, because HEB is
bomb. Yeah, HEB is bomb. You don't have to always go to you know, Whole Foods. People always sing here.
So what are y'all?
I need 2 days of food for $5 at HEB
for sure. What are y'all favorite
2 days of food for $5?
Because I get those little prepackaged ones.
The prepackaged ones.
Okay. Those are $5, and I got lunch every day for the week. That's how I've been doing, like the little pinwheel you saw today. It came.
Yeah, I seen that girl. I was like,
that was cute.
It was cool. It came two of
them. That was stuffed salmon. They stuffed salmon's good, huh? Ooh. Yeah, it's good. Ooh. Yeah, I don't know if these are the Houston folks, because I don't, it, you know, not a lot of places
have here. Everything's better.
Everything's better. But if y'all go to HEB, HEB definitely has some really good prepackaged meals.
And the meals, the hot meals too. Well, yeah. They're cold. You have to warm them up. But
yeah. And
produce section, I'm just blown.
And they sushi.
HEB has the best sushi. I was just going to say that. HEB has the best sushi.
You really need to go to like the Central Market ones, the Central Market HEBs, or the ones that have like both of them together with the restaurants and stuff. I feel like those are the best ones. Mm-hmm. Yeah. If you go to the ones that like not like that, they have them, but it's not as good.
Because my favorite one used to be in Siena. I used to only go to the Siena one. I don't like Pearland because it's too busy. But it's I found one by my house, finally down Buffalo Speedway in almost 59. Mm-hmm. And it's so nice. It was my first time going last week. I brought my kids. I'll never do that again.
She said, but I brought my kids like it was a field trip.
That's my time. And I just think, plan my week, plan my meals. But when they were there, I forgot stuff. They threw stuff in the basket. And I was just like, you know what? They were touching stuff, and like I was like, I'm distracted. No, but it's a very nice HEB, and I can't wait to go by myself.
Yeah,
HEB is good. They have really good guacamole. They have really good spinach.
I seen guacamole, and I was like, Chloe said it was really good.
They have really good guacamole. And I didn't pick it up, like, yeah,
I want to try their juice. I know you're talking about their juice, right?
Their squeeze juice. Yeah. Look, we're going to stop talking about HEB until they become a sponsor. Right.
Y'all sponsor that thing.
And we done plugging y'all HEB. Right. But no, I was going to ask.
That juice?
I was going to ask, what are y'all favorite healthy meals? Like your go-to, like I'm on a diet this week. What are your go-to, like, healthy meals?
My go-to meal is like a piece of salmon with like some broccoli and like some red potatoes. That's like it's like very easy. You can put it all in the oven all together, because potatoes take forever, and it'll be done in like probably like 40 minutes.
Right,
probably less than that, because fish don't take that long.
Yeah, yeah. I love a chopped salad. Like I love to prepare a salad. I love salad. Yeah. I had salad like three days this week.
Yeah.
Or stir fry. I like my little stir fry with my zucchini spirals and stuff like that. That was my go-to. I
cook
those in the morning for work.
I'm a salad girl. I don't love preparing salads because to me it takes too long, because I put a lot of vegetables in my salads. Right. Like onions, bell peppers, all kinds of stuff.
So all that.
Sitting there chopping it up, I get so annoyed. But
where do you go get
I love a good homemade I love my salads. I'll go, you know, to places and get, I like Subway salads.
Subway?
Yeah.
Subway has really good chopped salad.
Subway has
good
salad.
Have you ever gotten tuna chopped salad?
Yes.
Yo, with the it's so good. I never thought tuna in a salad would be good. It's so good.
I have to try it. I don't eat everybody's tuna. I'm a little scared of everybody's tuna.
No, Subway's tuna is decent.
It's decent.
Yeah.
Yeah, Subway has good salads. Gringo's has a very good Cobb salad. If nobody's been. Salada's good.
It's overpriced.
Yeah. I've never even been to Salada before.
It's good. But it's definitely expensive. Salada's one of them, like, once a week or month type places.
Expensive, like, what, $14?
Yeah. Like, $10, $12 for a salad. But you can put anything that you want. It's a decent size salad. It'll last you all day. Like, you can eat half now, half later.
Take your ass to Super Salad.
Yeah.
Look at Super. Me and my mom used to go to Super Salad.
Me and my mom
all the time.
Me and my mom still go to Super Salad.
Yeah.
Really?
But if I'm not eating a salad, I love some blackened tilapia. Some blackened tilapia with like zucchini and swats.
Now you know tilapia is a scavenger of the sea, right?
Just like catfish. I'm still eating. Ain't nobody goes.
But you know how it'd be so crazy how people used to like promote tilapia so much as being healthy. And they say it's not.
Nah. And according to my trainer, tilapia only is like one piece is 100 calories. So it's just like, it's not that many. Well, no, it's good.
Oh, okay.
It's like you need to eat a couple just to.
Oh, you're saying like, okay.
Yeah, because it's only 100 calories. Yeah. It's not that much. Okay. But Yeah, tilapia and scallops are my go-to.
Mess out of some tilapia.
My parents,
I would never fry tilapia.
Yeah, mama, it's good.
I will fry, blacken it and grill it before it. I'm always frying my catfish.
But the fry, it's
fried. Catfish nuggets, girl.
I've been blackening my catfish.
Yo, there's something about some that catfish meat be so thick. It's like a big, thick piece of drumstick, girl. It's so juicy.
That's why you need to have JJ's, girl. I have to bring you some.
Girl, I just don't understand how go from a tilapia, because you know tilapia kind of catfish nut.
Not a catfish fillet, but a nut.
That little curve kind of like
And it got that little. Oh!
Let me tell y'all why we need a trainer on this show. Because we sitting here talking about fried catfish, fried shrimp.
And that would have been like,
and the trainer would have been like, no. Calorie. Yeah, eat salmon.
Cholesterol.
Right. Salmon. I'm like, shit, I had a catfish once a week. And if I haven't fried, I eat it with like a salad.
Yeah.
Some green beans.
That's one thing I don't. I love green beans. I'll stay away from. Like when it comes to fried foods, like I will completely stay away from eating anything fried.
Yeah, me
when
too.
It comes it's to work, like being healthy.
Oh yeah, when I'm on a diet, it's so yeah, every like year when I go on Lent, I give up so much stuff like carbs, fried food, red meat, all that stuff, and I drop so much weight all the time. But even when I'm eating, just like when I take out carbs and fried food from my diet, and I don't eat sweets like that, and I don't drink soda.
Yeah.
So taking out those two, I maintain like a very good weight. I think carbs and fried food could be probably the worst. But one thing that I want to tell the babes, like, it's different strokes for different folks. Yeah. Like, a lot of people are always upset. Everybody's body is different. So, a lot of people, y'all could be on the same diet, but so-and-so may be losing weight a lot faster than another person. But that's because y'all body shapes are different. So, you really do have to figure out what works for you.
Yeah.
You really do.
You definitely do.
But it don't hurt to try because you won't.
Oh, absolutely not.
Until you try. Until you try what works for you. Yeah, yeah.
Only thing that works for me is green veggies and like a protein. And my protein now is either an egg because I love my eggs or fish.
I'm proud of you, Fanar, because it takes a lot to You scared to eat meat? Because, you know, every time people give up meat, they say when you give it up for a minute and you eat it again, you get sick.
See, that's what will keep me going.
You know what's so funny? Our friend Maya, she don't eat meat. And she's probably been going on a year plus some. Mm-hmm. And I think when she decided to give up meat, she had wanted to give it up for just like maybe a month or two. Mm-hmm. But then it got to a point to where, you know, she was coming up on her month or two and she was just scared to eat it again because she knew she would get sick. So she just kept it out of her diet. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And she's been going on almost probably 2 years now without any meat. I
just did it just to see what it would do to my body and what kind of effects since I am talking this way. See if it makes a major change. Because, like I said, I love chicken.
I cannot give up like a chicken taco.
Chicken breast. Because that's all I eat.
That's why I say my power to you. Because that's a lot.
Or a nice little chicken pasta.
We're horrible.
That's my thing.
Why did we do this? Why did we do this show without a trainer?
I had ravioli for dinner. I had the actual ravioli you get out the Italian section in the store.
Look at
that.
They
have like stuff in it.
The Italian section in the store.
Oh, girl, that's my favorite section. I love that.
We honestly wish we had someone who had these had this background so they could tell us the right things to do.
Right.
But seeing that our show is about us navigating through life, you know, on our own, we trying to figure it out.
We don't see if it works because
exactly. So if any babes, if y'all are trainers or if y'all are just into nutrition or are nutritionists. You know, we definitely drop us a comment or drop us an email or something. On the live, let us know y'all.
We had a couple of people, they kind of tuned in and tuned out.
We wrapping it up, right?
I love it.
Yeah, we are.
This is
good. This is a wonderful show.
I didn't think we're going to have much to talk about.
We spent 10 minutes trying to figure out if poop float. That's
But it's good to know.
But for real.
We all done put on gang today.
Yeah. So we're hoping that good this luck, time y'all. Y'all listening. I know. Good luck.
Let's check in every week with each other. We ain't got to do it on, you know, on air.
Yeah.
Let's check in. in.
Yeah. And we hope that y'all listen and pop this summer, y'all. Whatever y'all body goals are. And you probably are one of my body goals because I got a plan. I got a couple
of my body goals.
Thank you, boo.
Oh, thanks, girl.
So, yeah.
Work in progress.
Love you,
babe. Oh, and you know, one thing that you guys can do, babes, we're still looking for sponsors. Like, every week, if you're interested in being a sponsor, email us at brownsugarbaypod@gmail.com. Also, if there's anything that you want us to talk about, any topics, y'all, because we literally do be coming out with these topics on the top of our hands. If there's something that you want us to talk about, hit us up. Instagram, our email, just kind of let us know. We love to talk. That's why we started this podcast.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just let us know, and we'll make sure we get to it. And
be sure to follow us at Brown Sugar Babe Pod on Instagram.
Yeah.
Right?
Subscribe
on YouTube. We will be on Apple Podcasts very, very, very soon.
We are working on it.
We're working on it. And also on Twitter, a Brown Sugar Babe Pod as well.
We need to start playing with Twitter more. That's in our job.
It's in our retweet.
Yeah, I do sometimes, but when I gave up in social media,
she gave up us too.
That's a new Brown Sugar Bag.
Right.
We love y'all. We hope y'all have a fantabulous Thursday. It is hump day when you are listening to this episode. So get through it, boo. You got it.
Almost there, babe.
We behind you 100%. We love y'all. Talk to y'all later.
Mind your business. Down for all my nonsense, but I think I'm here to solve all my niggas don't mind.